it's Bekah, and welcome to the Carriage House, a place where you can find all kinds of cozy inspiration for your hearth and home. Today I'm in our newly renovated farmhouse kitchen that my husband just did, and gonna try and get it all warm and cozy for Christmas time. I was really excited. I actually got some new curtains for the kitchen. Initially, I had thought about getting some pretty red curtains just for this time of year, but then I saw these at Target, and I just thought they'd look pretty as a winter-themed curtain. The dark gray sort of reminds me of the sky before the snow's about to fall, and the white edging reminds me of a winter evergreen silhouette. And then I plan to add pops of red and green throughout the kitchen. So I'm going to start by doing a little hot chocolate and marshmallow bar in this little corner over here, and I have some pretty Magnolia Home green plaid cloth napkins that I bought in the hearth and hand section at Target. I'm gonna add some homemade chocolate mix over here that we made, along with some crushed peppermint and little mini marshmallows. Okay, so my husband is a woodworker, and he made this candy dispenser a very long time ago when my oldest son and daughter were very little, but I decided to put marshmallows in them, but probably should have chosen something else because only one or two, only like two or three actually, marshmallows come out at one time, and that's kind of funny because hardly anyone would want to just put too many marshmallows in their hot chocolate, but anyways, I thought it looked pretty in there, or you know, I'll just leave it for now and maybe add some like mini M&Ms, maybe like the red and green ones later on. You guys let me know if you have any ideas on, you know, any kind of like Christmas type of candy or holiday, something festive to put in here. Absolutely love these little oil lanterns, and this is actually a working one. I don't use it often, but when I do, I use olive oil in the base, and it has a wick here as well, but it does have to be carefully monitored in the home. But these lanterns remind me of the past, the days where people really knew what hard work was and taking care of the home, working in the fields day and night in order to survive, and it reminds me of a more simple and meaningful kind of life.
Was the night before Christmas, I was closing down for business in my little prison shop, when the bell on the door jingled once more, and then time almost came to a stop. But somehow
So I have these three containers on my kitchen countertop I bought at Target several years back. There's one for oatmeal, sugar, and brown sugar. And I had these Buffalo Check tea towels on hand, so I thought I would use them on the lids on the containers, kind of creating a jelly jar type of effect. I couldn't find my peaking shears, which is essential for hemming the edges, so I used just basic scissors, but I recommend if you're cutting fabric at home, using a good quality pinking shear. Also highly recommend using a fairly thin fabric, kind of like this one or even thinner, otherwise it'll make it difficult to seal the jars properly, as like kind of like what I'm doing. But this all ended up turning out nice, just a little added touch to the kitchen. And after this, I'm going to decorate a little tree in here with miniature jar type of cups that I found at Hobby Lobby, so it should be pretty fun. It'd be a nice kitchen Christmas tree type of theme. Decided to put one of those battery operated candles in our window. I kind of prefer the light from these ones compared to the LED ones that you plug in. These seem to have a softer glow and light to them, I feel. And I also took down my window screen, not only to attach my candle to the window, but it's wonderful to take down screens in your home for winter time because you can get more of that natural sunlight in your home. This really helps for those who have winters that can become really cold and dreary. And after I took my screen off, I really needed to wipe down and clean my window. And then I'm going to make a Christmas simmer pot on the stove, and this can make your home smell so wonderful and festive for the holidays. And it's all natural too, no Glade plug-ins or perfume scented candles, which can irritate you sometimes. And I try to use soy-based candles if I do light a candle in our home, and it's much more healthy for you as far as breathing in goes. But basically, you heat a pot of water on the stove on very low heat, and you add lots of fresh or dried fruits, herbs, and spices. To mine, I've added sliced oranges, whole cinnamon sticks, cloves, and allspice, I think. But you can add anything you like. You can add whole nutmeg, star anise, chopped or sliced apples, whole cranberries, fresh ginger would be nice, and you can even add those pine tree stems to the pot to get that amazing evergreen Christmas tree scent.